Welcome in, ladies and gentlemen. I know we're a little behind schedule, but that's all right. Thank you so much for waiting. It's time for Anime Weekly, your one-stop shop for all topics anime, anime-related news, anime-related anything. It's here we learn about the kawaii philosophy. Your hosts, Shelby McWeeb and Andrew J. Landy. Shelby, it's another rousing week. How are we tonight?
We're doing great. Speaking of doing great, we have a lot of food.
We have a smorgasbord of food here. And we have a lot of food because of our special guest. Is that correct?
We do have a lot of food because of our special guest.
Oh, my gosh.
Yeah.
Oh, my.
Not done yet.
Oh, my goodness. Oh, my damn.
I have two hands. But this is Marcus from Okamoto Kitchen.
All right. What's going on, Marcus?
Not much.
Not too much. you've brought
everything away in the kitchen.
My God. Like, I wish you guys could see the whole effect of everything that's on this table right now. We do have the anime figures and whatnot, but we are littered with food here, and it's kind of like nothing short of amazing. But anyway, folks, welcome to Anime Weekly, your one-stop shop for all things anime. If you are watching, again, make sure you've shared the stream out. Share it out Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, Snapchat, Vero, MySpace, doesn't matter where it is. Grab your next-door neighbor. Grab your greatest enemy. Sit him down with a nice, tasty beverage. Sit with us. It's time for Anime Weekly. Let's get into some of this. So our focus is honestly going to be on, well, the people that are here, our guest, Okamoto Kitchen. Marcus has agreed to show up and give us a little bit of insight about what Okamoto Kitchen's all about. But Shelby, am I missing something here?
So I couldn't decide between a theme. So half of it is Made Week and half of it is, you know how you see a lot of food in anime and you want to eat it? That's why this exists.
Okay.
So we're going to talk about we're going to talk about food, but we're also going to talk about maids, and I think that's the best way to spend our time.
Oh.
Maids are important.
Maids
are
very important.
Maids are pretty important.
So that's why we have this figurine here.
Why we have this figurine.
Okay.
Presenting Anime Weekly, our Anime Weekly logo to us.
Uh-huh.
It's also why I'm wearing this Child's Bridesmaid headband, a.k.a. the Rem headband.
Oh, from ReZero. Okay.
Yeah.
Perfect. Okay, so again, folks, if you have any comments that you want to say, again, this is also about you guys, you in the chat. So we want to hear from you. We've got the chat open.
Not any comments, but hopefully the best ones.
Yeah, well, we are vetting everything, but I do want to give quick shout-outs to Wes Saxon, Brianna DeCoster, Dakshin YT, Abner Senires. I do see the Overlord Elvin is in here. Daniel Somaleda. I got a lot of people to go through. Greg Hammer is in here. Kurt Rose, Jose Shady Solis. What is going on? Scott Spenner says, need more vegetables in your diet.
There's vegetables right here.
There's a lot of vegetables right here, right?
Vegetarian, vegan options.
Right?
It's poke.
Okay. It's poke? Okay.
Okay.
Good. Nice. I do see Marissa Lund and LD Maddox as well. Oh, yes. So
we're filled with fans.
Yeah, we got a lot of fans, so we've got a lot of questions to go through. Again, it's apparently a two-part episode. We've got Okamoto Kitchen in here, and we also have maids. It's a huge thing, so we're going to dive in. I do want to start off, though, with Okamoto Kitchen. And again, also, folks, if you have any questions that you'd like to ask, please put them in the chat. We will vet them out, of course, and we'll get that to them as fast as we possibly can. But first of all, Marcus, thanks for showing up. I mean, this is great. I mean, thank you. We went ham with everything here.
A little bit ham.
Yeah.
A little bit.
That's
a pun because there's lots of meat here as well.
Indeed. So, first of all, what is Okamoto
These are
Kitchen?
The jokes, people. Go ahead.
So, Okamoto Kitchen is a food truck. Mm-hmm. And also a booth that is owned by Gerald Abraham and Shizu Abraham. They're a food duo that came together several years ago.
Okay.
They were formed in about 2014, 15. We've been around for quite a while.
Uh-huh.
So we operate two trucks in the Los Angeles Valley area.
So there's two, okay.
And we also have a booth that we set up at events that we can't take the trucks to.
Okay, so two trucks, booths operated. Obviously, we see a lot of food here, but can you tell the people a little bit about what you serve and what's Okamoto's, claim to fame almost? Like, what is Okamoto all about, food,
So, a lot of people would say that we're maybe fusion food, but it's not exactly correct to call us fusion food. So,
okay.
We bring over Japanese dishes that are maybe less known to the American public.
Okay.
And we refine them for an American palate. So, one of our biggest successes is the katsu curry sandwich.
Okay.
So when you go into a curry restaurant, you get it's rice curry, and then you get like a cutlet of katsu like this.
Mm-hmm.
We got rid of the rice. We threw it on a sandwich and made it easy to eat on the go.
Okay.
And this is probably one of the most developed items that we have.
Ooh. Yeah, we've got a couple of those on here. Like, we've got one. We got a close-up on what Marcus is holding right there for the crowd who is at home and cannot witness or smell. I wish we had, like, smell-o-vision right now.
Right.
It would be totally perfect.
Maybe someday.
Maybe someday.
That was an April Fool's prank, like, a couple, like, many years ago. That was, like, one of the worst, like, the biggest April Fool's pranks was, like, I guess people tried to, there was an April Fool's Day prank where people tried to pretend that TV was now, like, smellified, and a bunch of people believed it. It was, like, psychosomatic, and then it wasn't real. And that's my fact of the day.
It was, like, fooled you.
Fooled you.
Yeah, already people chiming in the chat. Non-sponsored comment, by the way. Jose Shady Soli says, I had Okamoto Kitchen when they showed up to Super Arcade. Easily spent $40 on their tasty food. Second time, went to the 626 Night Fair. The food never disappoints. Again, this is a non-sponsored comment. This is just from a very hungry fan, Jose Shady Solis. Very good. Brianna DeCosta also saying, one of my go-to food trucks at K-Town Night Market and anime conventions. So, again, widespread when it comes to Okamoto. You guys... You said both L.A. and Orange counties, is that right?
We go to Orange County sometimes,
okay.
But generally in the L.A. area, or we will travel for large conventions. We were at Crunchyroll Expo in San Jose.
Right on.
I don't know why I did that. Like, I'm really supportive of Crunchyroll Expo. Shout out to Crunchyroll Expo. I had a great time.
Mm.
We go to Anime Expo every year, although that's local. Ronin Expo.
Okay.
ALA, that's in Ontario.
Yes.
Lots of good places. But yeah, they go to a lot of anime conventions, and I think it's cool to talk about how there's an anime-themed food truck kind of making the rounds and kind of becoming a part of the community. But tell us more about, like, a lot of these foods are foods that people have seen in anime. They're like, man, I really want to eat that, but I can't really find it anywhere here. So tell us more, a little bit more about, like, just kind of bringing it to, like, America with a refined palate, everything like that.
Well, one of the... probably most common food that you would see in anime is either curry, ramen, or karaage, which is chicken, right? Is the fried chicken that we have here. Offer it in two different styles. One is the Okamoto style, which is a garlic teriyaki glaze over the chicken with green onions and sesame seeds.
Mm.
And to make that more of a well-rounded, more balanced meal, we throw in salad over, and then we have that over rice as well, if you wanted a meal. But we can also serve it as like an individual thing as just the chicken. And if you're not really into, you know, garlic teriyaki or sauces on your chicken and you want to have it, you know, the old classic izakaya style,
okay,
we offer it as a classic style, and that's just plain with mayo and lemon. It's really great. Most people won't think about that combination. But it's really good when you eat it together.
That's good. More people chiming in the chat, by the way. Dana Din Wen says, you guys are my go-to truck at any con I see you at. I can definitely vouch for that because, actually, that is also my belief. You guys are the go-to for me whenever I'm at a convention. Shelby can definitely vouch for you guys as well. I don't want to speak for Shelby.
Thank you so much.
Yes.
Don't talk over me.
Sorry.
A lot of people messaged me. They're like, I can't find the stream. Where's the stream? Okamoto's going to be on. So I'm like, cool. But do you have a favorite? I don't mean to catch you off guard, but is there an anime where you can think of that has the best drawings of food?
Oh, man.
Right? Think about that. You can come back, but...
That's not Food Wars, because that's kind of cheating. Let's be real.
Okay, so if Food Wars was completely off the table...
Off the table.
Oh, man. I would probably have to say that Fate anime that just came out that releases an episode every, like, 3 weeks. It's like, was it Cooking with Soma? Shiro?
Cooking with Shiro, yeah. Mm. That is the best route that you can take in the Fate universe.
Okay.
That's the only route that's acceptable to take, is Cooking with Shiro.
But... I think the Ghibli illustrations of food are probably just as on par as that is.
Ponyo, for sure.
Okay. Very good.
Fun fact, Noah Cyrus was the voice of the English dub of Ponyo, if you need like that throwback.
Hey, which could come in handy because, again, folks, like we've done in the past, just want to make sure we put this out there. There will be a giveaway. Three lucky winners may win some epic swag. Just to give the people an example, what do we have in store for our loyal viewers tonight?
So we recently launched a e-commerce site to diversify our brands, you know, not just food. And just push into different avenues so we can be more of a participant at conventions, you know. We're not always just stuck outside of the convention selling food, but we actually want to be more of a part of the community. We want to have people, you know, show what their support. We have keychains, we have t-shirts, which you can see that we're all wearing. We have posters. We have rubber keychains.
Okay.
We might have a figure in the works soon. We have a prototype here on the desk.
Nice. Okay. Best girl. So this is best girl.
Best girl.
Best girl. The maid.
Everyone named Haru is best girl. Okay. I don't make the rules.
Okay.
I do make the rules. Everyone named Haru is best girl.
Haru is apparently best girl now. You know, if
universally,
if Haru the maid is serving food like this, I can definitely see why she'd be considered best girl.
She's also serving looks.
Mm-hmm. Indeed. Okay, so a couple of people in the chat actually chiming in. They are also all agreeing with you. Amanda Stewart and both Dana Nguyen are saying any Ghibli film is always a solid choice. So, and Dana is also saying, I'm going to advertise your food with my juicy thighs. I'm not sure what that means.
Is that a threat?
That I don't know. By the way, Marcus, they are asking, Brianna DeCoster is asking, where are the Haru et cosplays at? Is this a thing?
So on the show that Utahime was on, mm-hmm. She suggested that we made a plan to turn Haru into the next Bowsette. Thoughts? Okamoto Kitchen?
Please do not lewd our maid daughter.
Okay, that doesn't mean automatically. You're not going to automatically lewd Haru, but...
Rule 34.
No, please. First of all, I don't think that Bowsette exclusively lewd. Uh-huh. However, Bowsette is lewd. Mm. But what about turning Haru into some kind of like, oh, I'm Ghost Haru.
Oh.
Ghost Haru.
I'm Maid Haru.
Maid Haru. Okay.
I'm what other versions? There's like, I'm trying to think of figures. Well, I'm Racing Haru. Racing Haru. I want to be Racing Haru.
There are many versions of Haru out, actually. And
are
if
there?
You followed us since, you know, way back in the early days, and you followed our holiday promotions, you'd realize that we actually do have a Valentine's Day version of Haru.
Ooh.
We have a Halloween version of Haru, which recently passed, you might have seen earlier. And we actually have a pinup version of Haru on our classic 1956 shirt.
Speaking of shirts, by the way, Ariel Ningyo is saying, Shelby, I love your shirt. Where can I get one? So,
ooh, that's
a great question, actually. Yeah. So what is the shirt that we have here? Marcus,
says,
you might know about this as well. Yeah.
Top tier waifu.
Top tier?
Top tier waifu.
Validates my statement that everyone named Haru is a top tier waifu.
Okay.
It says top tier waifu. Mm-hmm. But, you know, I think it's great to have a shirt that says top tier waifu because it does bring a big waifu energy to anything you do.
Mm.
I feel like top tier waifu gets thrown around a lot, but it should be because, you know, you're a top tier waifu. Haru's a top tier waifu.
Mm.
I'm a top tier waifu. You got to bring that energy everywhere you go.
Mm. Okay.
I don't know. I'm trying.
So if you notice, each of us is wearing a piece of Okamoto, the Okamoto brand gear. So we all have our different shirts on. Obviously, the top tier waifu, as shown by Shelby. And both Marcus and I are I think we're repping two sides of the same shirt. Is that correct?
That is true.
Oh, nice.
Can you imagine if you were like in an alleyway and a bunch of people with like Okamoto Kitchen shirts just start beating you up?
Oh, the Okamoto
They're
gang?
Not going to, but just like think about it.
No, we're going to force karage into your mouth and force you to eat it.
Right. By the way, question from the chat, actually. Marissa Lund is asking, do you offer just garlic karaage?
So, again, the karaage, we call it JFC to make it easier. Most Americans can't pronounce karaage.
Right, okay.
So, to make it relatable, you know, KFC, JFC, Japanese fried chicken.
Japanese fried chicken, right.
So, again, it comes in two styles. It's a classic and Okamoto style. Classic is plain with a mayo and lemon. So, if your garlic isn't quite your thing, or maybe you have a date later on that night, you might want to go for the classic version.
No, I'd rather fight vampires. I'm going to go with the garlic. I'm not going to
Yeah, what if your date is a vampire and you don't know that yet? I think that's that's like a form of protection.
Right? Who knows?
So, yeah.
Okamoto could be the very reason why, you know, we're able to save ourselves if we got to go fight like Dracula.
Okamoto saves.
Okamoto saves. Hashtag Okamoto saves.
New shirt.
Okay. Before we continue again, I want to give everybody a quick thank you for joining us here on Anime Weekly, your one-stop shop for all topics anime. Your hosts, Shelby McWeave and Andrew J. Landy, were joined by Marcus Chavez of Okamoto Kitchen. Again, if you haven't done so already, make sure you've shared out the stream, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, all sorts of social media. If you guys want to learn about the world of food trucks, of course, and you'll also post up using the hashtag Okamoto Saves. Why not? If you definitely share it out. If you guys want to learn one, about Okamoto Kitchen, and two, maids. Is that correct,
maids.
Shelby?
And yes. We're going to dive into the maids world because God, is that ever a world. However, we would like you to be liking Okamoto Kitchen and Anime Weekly in order to participate in the giveaway.
So if you guys didn't hear me earlier, there is a giveaway that will be happening later on in the broadcast. So I believe three lucky people are going to win some epic swag. There's a... I believe these keychains are part of it. Is that correct?
So we're going to give away prizes to three lucky winners. So the first one is going to be a charm set, and it's an acrylic charm set that we've developed over the past year. And there's six of them, so you're getting all of them all at once.
Whoa, so you get all the whole set. Nice.
And the second one is going to be a vinyl keychain set, Andrew is holding.
So this is the vinyl keychain set right here. Okay. Yeah, my hands are too big, so sorry. I'm trying not to block them. There we go. Let's get a better shot there. We're going to spread them out real quick. So this is the second prize. Is that correct?
Yes.
Okay. And then there's one more. Is that right?
So the last prize is actually going to be a bit of a choice for whoever wins.
Oh.
So the last prize, grand prize, is going to be viewer's choice of one shirt off our website.
Oh, okay. So and these shirts, what's the website so that if anybody's in the chat right now, they can kind of jump into the site and kind of plan their victory. Where should they go for that?
So our e-commerce site is okamotok-shop.com.
Okay.
But you can also get there from just our regular website, okamotokitchen.com.
Okay.
And when you go to our landing page, it'll ask you whether you want to see food or whether you want to see merch.
Oh, okay.
There are two ways to get
there. That's Sophie's choice.
Right. You win either way.
Dark joke.
Terrible.
Okay. And you did not answer the question. What anime do you think of when you think of like food that you want to eat?
When I think of food I want to eat, all I can think of is Fate Stay Night. Not because I'm just obsessed with it, but because
that's why. Go on. But shut don't up. Pretend that's not the reason you're mentioning Fate Stay Night. Who are you trying to impress? Please go on.
Shiro cooks a lot.
That's true. And so does Sakura.
And Sakura too. Yeah. So. I can't go wrong with that. That's the first thing.
Saber eats a lot.
Yes, she does.
So we have two for Fate. I'm gonna throw like the curveball. I'm gonna say Sailor Moon I grew up. You know, I was in my teen years, so I started getting into anime. I started watching lots of Sailor Moon, so that introduced me to a lot of like the really good food that you see here. Actually, when I was a teenager, I really was upset. What got me hooked on like what made me think about food a lot was actually it was either Air or Kanon.
The key anime?
Yeah, the key anime. I liked Taiyaki a lot. Man. I just liked the idea of it. I knew that I wouldn't like red bean paste because I was 14 and I only ate like french fries.
Oh my gosh, Rihanna is right. Usagi is always eating, by the way.
Yeah, she's always eating.
That's true. That's very true.
They're always out eating. They're like, oh, let's go to this fancy cafe. Even though we're 14, we don't have jobs. We can always afford like full course Sunday
like
meals.
Straight broke, right?
Yeah.
You know, how are you?
They're always at the arcade. They're always at the restaurant with all these cute boy waiters. Like, oh, all the waiters are 15-year-old and hot. Like, what a, oh, weird. This is, I have problems. You don't have problems. You're fucking 15. I mean, that was really aggressive at, you know, Sailor Moon, and I apologize to her.
You apologize for nothing.
I apologize for nothing. She ate such really pretty and really good food. They got me hooked on, like, thinking about food all the time. But also Air TV, for some reason. That's what I think of whenever I think of anime food. I was obsessed with it because of that anime. And I ate Taiyaki when I moved here, and I'm never going to be as happy in my life as I am when I'm eating that. At any venue, anywhere I go, that is like, I waited 10 years to eat that food. So that's what I think of when I think of anime food.
Not to rain on your parade, but the Taiyaki place that opened a year ago closed recently.
Which one? Snowya?
Snowya. Where are you going to get your Taiyaki now, Shelby?
Why did you do this to me? I'm on camera.
Where are you going to get it?
Well,
I mean, there's other places. It'll just have to be seasonal.
Right.
Like my happiness.
So a couple of comments in the chat saying, I wish the food trucks were in North Carolina, says G. Valerie Bernhardt. Jason Logan saying, man, I am from Austin, Texas, food truck city, so bringing back good memories here. Tracy Cowan says, hi, I'm from Tasmania. How are you guys? Tasmania, that's a new one.
Yo.
Congratulations. So Tasmania tuning in, I'm assuming loving the food here. I haven't even...
Do you have Taiyaki?
Yeah, probably. So, by the way, Jonathan Hu and Tim Timtastic No are both in the chat as well. So,
the dream team.
The dream team is here. Marcus, I'm going to ask you a question. So what does it take to run not just your food truck, but any food truck in general?
Well, you need maids.
You need
lots
maids.
And lots of maids.
We need lots of maids? Okay, like a maid army.
Yes.
Okay.
Second, you need blood, sweat, and tears.
Blood, sweat, and tears? Okay.
Third is time.
Uh-huh.
And fourth is a very large bankroll.
Okay, so a very large bankroll. Like, how much would it, like, does it cost to attend an event for Okamoto? Just out of curiosity.
So it really depends on the event that we're going to. Mm-hmm. And that's what makes it difficult for us to actually expand into specifically convention events.
Okay.
Anytime we're at a convention or a hotel con, we work out agreements months in advance, sometimes
a
year in advance to attend these events that everyone loves us for. And a lot of the times we put out the paperwork and you will ask, hey, can we want to attend this event? We'll either talk to the organizer of the event itself or a third party booker or the convention center / hotel, whoever it is that's in charge of actually running the space. Or we have the organizer talk to them on our behalf.
Okay.
And a lot of times when we attend these events, the venue will request a percentage of our sales.
Okay, that makes sense.
To attend. And,
right.
So if it's something like a regular lunch stop, like not an event, not a catering, it could be free, like just a spot that we've developed over the course of time. It could be through a third party booker that has a cache of stops that we rotate through, you know, monthly or you know, bi-monthly. Those stops can range anywhere from like $20 to $70, $120. It just all depends on how good the spot is.
Okay.
And if somebody needs service in those areas.
Okay. Oh, it sounds pretty intense, not gonna lie. So didn't know that it could be a free spot or like you said, a year in advance to book at an event. That's insane. So now I know that Okamoto Kitchen has done anime collaborations too with partners like Atlas or Omocat. Mindfair, can you talk a little bit about that?
Yeah, for sure. So
I never saw it coming.
Really?
Really?
God.
Really?
Shelby,
I'll be back.
Contain your excitement really quick. Oh my gosh, my co-host is leaving me. I don't know what's going on. But yeah, Marcus, tell us a little bit about Okamoto and the anime collaborations you guys have done.
So one of the biggest anime collaborations that we've ever done was we partnered with Atlas Games.
Uh-huh.
And we created a line of Persona-themed food that was special for Anime Expo. We've done that for the past 2 years.
Uh-huh.
At first, they were pretty hesitant about it, but after we showed them, you know, this is what we can do, and sent them samples, they absolutely loved us, and they've asked us back a lot of the time. So every time we go to Anime Expo, we bring both of our trucks out. It's our event, you know,
we're
the anime, you know,
like
FTC food truck.
Yes.
That's where we belong. So we have one of our trucks branded with, you know, just our Okamoto stuff, and we try to do a special, you know, Okamoto brand stuff. Menu on that truck only, and then we do the collaboration truck, and that whole truck, the menu board is completely revamped.
I was unaware of that. That's insane.
Usually we do two different types of combos, and there are dishes, and we usually develop one dish or drink in addition to what our current menu is, and we brand that as the Persona item. The year before last, we had the LeBlanc curry, you know, the Phantom Thieves set.
Oh,
no, Shelby.
I saw it coming. Go on. Keep going.
And this year, we developed a special blue drink for the new Persona that's coming out. We called it Moonlight Punch, in addition to the previous drink that was on the year before, which is now our Okamoto Punch. We named that Starlight Punch.
Okay.
So while you guys are talking, I've been thinking a long time about what this show needed to make its edge. And I just thought of it now. So I hope you guys I hope you guys will play along with me. So we're gonna keep talking, but Marcus, in a maid cafe, what's a game that maids play with their customers that there's penalties for?
Oh no.
It could be anything really simple from rock, paper, scissors to just karaoke.
I'm going to ask, you guys are going to, later, we're going to talk about maids a little bit, but you guys are going to ask
maids.
Me questions. And.
Wait, what? I'm so
confused. You have trivia questions, right?
I have trivia questions.
So the punishment game we're going to play is I'm going to be blindfolded. You're going to ask me, you're both going to ask me questions about anime. They can be super easy or super hard. If I get them right, you guys give me Okamoto Kitchen food, but if you guys are wrong, you put something else in my mouth. I don't know what it's going to be. Your turn.
What?
No, that's gross. Don't go there.
What?
Rob, find things that would be wrong to put in my mouth.
Lauren in the chat says, Shelby, you were made for this.
Ooh.
Rob, please block Larny from the stream. Okay.
Okay.
So this is going to be the game we play later on, all
right? I'm so worried for you right now.
Rob, you know what you have to do.
Shout out to Engineer Rob, by the way. The meme slinger. Yes, he's dabbing in the back, even though he's really not. But yes, I'm expecting that. Do the work in there. Okay. Now that I've completely been thrown off my train of thought because Shelby, I was not expecting this. I'm not going to lie. Well done. So huge collaborations on there. Now, I do understand, I don't know if I'm jumping the gun here on this, what are some of Okamoto's future plans? Can you dive into, you know, give us a little teaser at this point, or is there stuff that's like hush-hush I'm not allowed to say?
Well, a little bit of it's hush-hush. Okay. A lot of it's maybe bombshell status.
Oh, it's bombshell, you say?
So it's no secret that we want to have an anime.
Oh, okay.
And we've spent a lot of time in this last year developing many assets and things that will go along with that.
Uh-huh.
Most important.
Most importantly, Maid Haru, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so a lot of assets going into it. It's an anime. Is there any detail you can share with us right now to whet the appetite of our fans, or do we just have to stay tuned?
I can tell you that it's going to be about real life experiences and things that you would never see in an anime. It's going to be very American. So a lot of anime, you know, back in the day, it was Japanese artists creating Japanese work, you know, anime. Mm. And then there was like a second wave of that where it was American artists that were influenced by, you know, Japanese work.
Mm.
And those people are now like creating the same thing, but from an American perspective, and it's very different. If you can think of an anime that like has that kind of feel.
Okay.
Anyone out here watch Eden of the East?
Yes. Eden of the East, yes.
So the first episode takes place in DC.
It's been a long time.
Oh, wow. Yeah.
The characters and the backgrounds and everything about the feel of that episode is, it feels very different, and I think that they consulted a lot of people, an artist in America to create that.
Okay.
It did, yeah.
I'm sorry, I totally just took a bite on screen, so did Shelby, and I'm wondering if they can hear our chewing.
I have been all day.
So. Really?
Are we providing free ASMR?
Something like that, right? I think it's time. By the way, guys, I think it's time. You know, I've been holding back because like I've been munching on the fries a little bit. So as Engineer
That's
Rob.
That's why I went to play the game.
Oh.
So I could eat food.
Okay, so you know what? Shall we just transition into Shelby's weird game?
Okay.
Of,
you both have to talk about your favorite maid animes each, though, while I'm gone. Marcus goes first.
Mark, as you knock over your microphone. Marcus, I'm going to give you a little time to think about your favorite maid anime.
No, he knows his favorite maid anime. Don't give him that. Well, don't pretend he doesn't have, like, a top 10 list right off the bat. You say it.
Well, here's the thing. I'm going to get... While Marcus gets himself ready, I am going to say, hey, everyone, thanks for joining us on Anime Weekly. Our guest tonight is Marcus Chavez of the one and only Okamoto Kitchen. Again, if you haven't shared out the stream, make sure you are sharing out on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, any sort of social media that you have. Again, there will be a giveaway later on for some sweet Okamoto Kitchen swag. I just wanted to take one moment, of course, to promote one of the events that's going on for Nerdbot next year, which is Anime Pasadena. That's going on at the Pasadena Convention Center April 20th. I believe the vendor and artist registration is about to go live. That's going live soon, I believe, later this month if it hasn't gone so already. Just a quick question though: is it possible Okamoto Kitchen? Maybe I'm not guaranteeing anything. That will neither confirm nor deny. But is there a chance we could see Okamoto at Anime Pasadena?
I would say it's a possibility.
It's a possibility. Okay, so for those of you who are wondering, again. Anime Pasadena, that's going on April 20th at the Pasadena Convention Center. Visit, I believe. Hey, Engineer Rob, do you have that drop for Anime Pasadena, by the way? Do you have that, like, a flyer for Anime Pasadena? Do you have anything I could look at right now? which is fine if you don't, because honestly, it's a great event. It'll be the second year that it's happened, and oh my God, what is going on here? Anyway, Anime Pasadena, April 20th, that's going on. I believe you can go to nerdbot.com for more details. That is going to be a fun time, and of course, Okamoto Kitchen could very well possibly be there. So if you guys wanted to try any of the delicious food that Okamoto Kitchen has, that's where you want to be. Again, April 20th, Anime Pasadena, gonna be a fun time. Okay, so just jumping into the chat really quickly before we continue on. Ivory Ice Han says, don't say it'll be nothing you've seen before. You know what happened when High Guardian Spice said that. Is that right,
Shelby? How dare.
Right?
I support High Guardian Spice. Don't kill me. Mm. But I support High Guardian Spice. I think it's great that Crunchyroll is trying to make original content. Mm. And they're going for it, and they're working in Burbank. So keep it up, Guardian Spicers.
Okay. So before we go, Shelby, is are you completely blind right now?
Yes.
Marcus, before we begin... Don't do that, Engineer Rob. Marcus, before we begin, we did ask about... favorite made animes. You obviously know you are superior in intellect to me in that regard. Tell us a little bit about some of your favorites before we begin.
So right off the bat, we got to mention ReZero.
Yes, we have to. You have to.
It's a Citizen Kane of made anime.
Oh my God, right? See, like, I don't really know too much about, you know, anime focusing on maids. I just see a certain point where someone is going to dress up as a maid.
Your favorite maid is Rin Tosaka. Let's just cut to the chase.
Shut up.
I see we're both very predictable.
Yeah, she knows us too well. Okay, so obviously going with Rem, is that right?
Yep.
Okay.
Do you have any other favorites? Any other series you can touch on?
Kobayashi's Maid Dragon.
Oh God.
Okay. I get. You know what? That works too. I'm not gonna lie. Shelby, can you talk about that one?
Oh my God. That's the other Citizen Kane of... They're all the Citizen Kane of made anime because they're all good. I love Miss Kobayashi Dragon Maid. Tohoru is best girl.
Okay.
Tohoru. And then I think Maid-sama is a good anime because it's a shoujo, specifically about a girl who doesn't really have an interest in cosplaying as a maid, but she needs to earn money for her family. She joins a maid cafe because she looks like the owner's waifu.
Okay.
The owner is like a 40-year-old woman who just really likes games a lot. And she just like learns the ins and outs of maid cafe. Also, Blend S. Does that count?
I think it counts.
It should count. Blend S is also a masterpiece, but not Citizen Kane. Let's call it Chinatown.
Oh gosh.
It's Chinatown of maid anime.
What about Ivory Eyes Han is asking, what about Maid Guy? Is that a thing? Maid Guy.
Maid Guy. How's she spelling it?
As in maid guy, like
male maids?
Yeah, I don't know.
That's host club, isn't it?
Yeah, we call this butlers.
Yeah,
butlers, hosts, yes.
Hosts.
Or in host club.
I guess that counts too. I don't know too much about maid animes. I just remember specifically Carnival Phantasm and Saber.
Maid Saber
becoming Maid Saber Alter.
Yes.
And it was the most beautiful thing.
Carnival Phantasm. Is very good. I don't know. I can't even joke. I can't even make a fake. We're like, oh, Ben-Hur of maid. It's really good. Carnival Phantasm is really good. Yes. They took a chance. They went with a new production company to make that anime. It was like, you know, didn't really, you know, just went for it. And they did a really good job. Carnival Phantasm is one of the funniest animes I've ever seen and the most I've ever enjoyed the Fate universe. And I spent a really long time in the Fate universe.
We're still in the Fate universe. Let's not lie here.
If you don't have time to watch all of Carnival Phantasm, please do yourself a favor and just watch the opening. Yes.
You will never see me do that ever again.
It's live. It's recorded.
Yeah, no. You're going to have to gift that, okay?
My brother and I, every Christmas, we watch all of Carnival Phantasm.
Nice. Okay, so Chad is chiming in. Hanakuyo Maid Team says Chris saying. Also, Common No Maid Guy. That's, I think, the reference there. Tim Tiptesno says Lance and Masks has a kick ass maid. Love Live also has an episode centered around a maid cafe. Is that true?
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah, that's. What's it?
Okay.
The little.
Okay.
Do you guys get my reference? Comment if you get my reference.
Yeah, comment if you get Shelby's reference. Okay, so. I guess this. So I guess let's transition into the game here. So okay. Shelby doing her best 2B impression.
Yeah. I mean, 2B has a maid outfit.
Yeah, that's true. That's very true. So 2B
honestly,
counts.
If we're gonna go this route, most anime characters have a maid outfit. Like it's pretty K-on. Uncommon. Yeah. Oh, K-on.
K-on. Okay.
Oh, that's a good. Yeah. This is a good week.
Yeah, right. It's a good week because Shelby's blindfolded, and now we're gonna put random objects in her mouth.
I love maid versions of all of my favorite characters.
Okay.
If they don't have a maid version, they're not real.
Okay, Shelby, can you confirm you see absolutely nothing?
Yes.
Okay, you are completely blind. How many fingers am I holding up?
Enough.
Okay.
Enough.
Well done. So, Shelby, explain this game to us again so that we know what exactly we're doing.
This is a punishment game, like in maid cafes.
Okay.
I want to eat Okamoto Kitchen food, and I know it would be really, really rude for me to just start eating on stream because I tried to find an opening to start eating, but there wasn't one until I thought about this, and this is a punishment game. So you guys are going to ask me questions. They don't even have to be about anime.
Are we about to have an Okamoto mukbang?
I think we're just going to have an Okamoto mukbang right now.
Teach you what that
Let's
means.
Let's do it.
So, Marcus, can you tell us what mukbang is?
So it's actually Korean. A lot of people will get copious amounts of food or like a large quantity of one specific type of food, and they will go live on stream and they will finish this food or attempt to try to finish the food. And a lot of women will try and do this, and they've gained thousands and thousands of followers just doing this. I haven't seen mukbang recently. Maybe it was a trend that died out like 2 years ago or so, but
damn it,
it is still very much alive.
Okay. I'm sorry, I just started eating. I couldn't help myself. I'm not blindfolded.
Okay.
But this is what happens when you do it. You just eat, and it's good. It's like social eating, right? This is really rude of me to speak my mouth full, but goddamn it, the food is so fucking it's so good.
Thank you.
So what I brought is.
Okay,
I brought whipped cream, which is a food, but it's also not fun to be hit with. I bought a Nerd Playgirls pin, available Nerd Playgirls.
Mm-hmm.
I bought a cork, because it's confusing, because I'll think, oh, it's chicken, but it's not. And I got...
But Shelby, you selected all of these items yourself.
I did. Rob didn't help me.
I mean...
I don't know what he's doing.
It's okay, we have other things we can give you.
Okay, cool.
Phrasing.
All right, you're...
Phrasing.
You're welcome to choose. All right. But if I guess right, you have to give me food.
Okay.
Sounds good.
Marcus, okay. Will you do the honor of the first question? And again, folks, this is the punishment game. So if Shelby gets the question right, and the question doesn't have to be an anime question, if she gets it correct, she gets to eat delicious, delicious Okamoto Kitchen food. Again, thank you to our guests here tonight, Okamoto Kitchen. If she gets it wrong...
If someone in the comments wants to ask questions too, if you guys have the answer to it, you're welcome to take that too.
Mm. So yes, I will be looking through the chat for questions as well. Engineer Rob and Michael Powell from earlier are also looking for other random objects as well. So, all right, Marcus, do you have a question ready?
In the Studio Ghibli movie, Ponyo by the Cliff, what is the food that Ponyo is crazy about? More specifically.
Oh, egg.
Wrong.
Right? No, it's ramen. I said it right. Fine.
It's ham.
Damn, damn, damn! Oh,
open
no.
Up.
Okay, so here we go. Shelby cannot see anything right now. All right, here's the first object. Here you go. Oh, my God. Oh, no. Okay, you can spit it out now. Is it okay? No, no.
I have next question.
Yeah. Oh, do you have to? What?
Wow.
She has to. Okay, so
okay.
She's going double punishment. Marcus, I'm gonna rely on you totally for questions at this point right now, because someone has to steer the ship. Okay. Okay.
In Orin Host Club, what is the item from episode 1 that Haruhi breaks?
It's a vase.
Correct.
Okay, good. Okay, you know, first of all, let's get somebody hand me a napkin really quick. That way, because I'm not touching that. It was in her mouth, man.
A lemon.
Yes, so that was lemon. Okay, Shelby, I'm going to give you, in your other hand, I'm going to give you a towel. So there you go. There's a towel you can place. There you go, sunshine. Okay. So then, what we're going to do, since she got a question correct, congratulations. I don't know how much of this torture I can really take.
We've only gotten two questions in.
And I don't know how much torture I can take of this. Mostly because I'm just like, I can't even eat this food right now. Although I just took a giant piece of chicken. That's fine. So if you guys are, just tuning in, welcome to Anime Weekly. This is your one-stop shop for all things anime and anime-related topics. Again, your hosts, Shelby McWeeb and Andrew J. Landy. Shelby McWeeb right now is doing a punishment game, a Batsu game, more or less, where if our guest...
Good, bro. Good.
Okay, there we go. Open take up. Take a... open up, say ah. Wait for the plane.
It's a food truck.
It is. It's a food truck. That's right. So driving it in. So,
it tastes like Persona 5.
It does. So if here's the thing. If Shelby gets the question right, and it doesn't have to be anime related, she gets to take a bite of delicious food from Okamoto Kitchen. If she gets the question wrong, however, there will be something random going into her mouth. Phrasing. I get it.
Like a lemon.
Like a lemon. So the first round, she got the question incorrect. It was a lemon that got put in. The second round, though, she got correct. So she got to eat, what was it? That was like delicious curry?
Curry.
It was curry?
Curry.
Very good. Okay. Oh, God. So I'm going to ask. I feel so bad asking this question. I'm gonna go with one. Okay. By the way, folks, if you have a question in the chat, I will take some requests. I won't take all of them, though. So here's the next question. And if I don't hear the right answer from this one, you're screwed. By the way, Chris saying you need to quote it correctly. Marcus knows exactly where I'm going with this. What is the airspeed velocity of an unladen swallow?
Oh, shit. I forget the fucking gift. Oh, why am I cussing? I'm sorry.
Because we're allowed to.
It's the.
Five.
It's the.
Four.
It's the, like, you don't
three,
know. I don't remember the reference.
Two,
I was scared one, of the movie because he cut his arms
wrong,
off.
It's wrong. Punishment time.
So, Marcus, would you do the honor of selecting an item here? By the way, the correct answer is, is that an African or European swallow?
And go off a fucking cliff.
Oh, no. Oh, okay. Okay, ready? Go for it.
Oh!
What is it? Do you even know what that is? Oh, God. What is... okay, do you really want to know what it is?
Yeah.
It's your fork.
Oh. I thought there was something on the fork, so I'm like, I can't put my tongue down.
Okay. Marcus, do you need a moment? Because I do have another question.
Go ahead.
Okay. Shelby, you could redeem yourself for this if you do know this. I actually do know this question. This one comes courtesy of Tim Tim Tesk. No?
I thought you were my friend.
No, wait. I'm gonna get to yours later. Trust me. Yours is next. Who was Bill Clinton's Republican opponent in the 1996 presidential election? Oh my God, this is amazing.
Best idea ever.
Fucking hell. Who was it?
10.
Bill Clinton?
9.
Well, it was Clinton's 8, opponent.
Al Gore was his vice president. 6, it was Bush 5, Senior?
Nope.
4.
Fuck.
Wrong.
No. The answer is Bob Dole.
Oh, fuck.
I actually knew that, by the way.
Punishment.
Marcus, would you do the honors? I have no idea what I can use here. I'm just going to let Marcus punish her the entire
time. I don't know 1996 memes.
Okay. So, Marcus is choosing items. Oh, no. Oh, no. Oh, God. Oh, my God.
I can't keep this in my mouth.
Phrasing.
I'm not chosen.
Phrasing. Oh, God. Oh, jeez. Okay. This is
rest
so.
Rest in peace, Stanley.
Yeah. Oh, jeez. I can't right now with.
No actual rest in peace though. Yeah, I just think I don't know why this reminded me that I wanted to give it a tribute. This is probably the wrong time, but like.
Yeah. Too soon, homie. Yeah.
No, it wasn't like a joke. I mean, like actual rest in peace.
No worries. Tim actually thought you would know that. Believe it or not, I actually didn't. I did know that, by the way. So, Marcus, do you have a question ready, or would you like to go with the next one?
Sure.
Go for it. Okay. Go for it. And I'm totally going to take a bite of this chicken, by the way. Sucker.
I can't.
Mm-hmm.
In the popular Makoto Shinkai movie, Your Name, what is the name of the comet that is a major plot point?
I actually don't know that. I just think she actually knows this. It's amazing.
I'm thinking about...
I'm going to give you 10 seconds.
J.J. Abrams.
Oh.
Do you get the joke?
Oh, no. I mean, that's 10 right there.
That was a reach.
Okay, Marcus, what's the answer? How are we? We're just going to punish her the entire night.
Do you know the answer?
The answer is Tiamat.
Tiamat. Also the name of a popular summon in the Final Fantasy series, Tiamat. Okay, so.
Punishment.
Punishment. What is the next item? Oh, gee. This is terrible.
I just want you to pick them.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Oh, God. Oh, God. This is...
Oh, it's a glow. What the fuck? Okay. I'm going to grab my comments.
Okay.
Help.
Shelby, I might be nice to you real quick. I may be nice for a change. Because I'm gonna save a certain question for later. Are you sure you okay?
Uh-huh.
Okay. Shelby?
Uh-huh.
Where can the people follow you? What is your social media handle?
Which one?
You get one shot.
Pick.
At symbol. The... T-H-E bomb B-O-M-B shell S-H-E-L-L cosplay.
Yeah!
C-O-S-P-L-A-Y.
Alright, yay! Oh my gosh.
On Instagram.
Well done. Alright, Shelby, open up for the food truck. Here it comes. No, the other way. No, yeah. This episode is insane. Holy shit. Okay.
I'm glad that I know that salmon, because I'd be scared if I didn't know it was salmon. It tastes really good.
Wrong.
Wait, it's not salmon?
It's tuna.
Does that constitute a...
No. That doesn't count.
That does not count. Okay. Very good. I thought I'd be nice to Shelby. But this time, we're going to do a couple more questions. What do you think, Marcus? How many more rounds of this do you think she should do?
We can go back to talking about maids soon.
I think we should let the audience decide the next question.
I think, yeah, so I'm going to take one. I already have one loaded up, and then we're going to take another audience question. I'll let you pick that one, Marcus, so keep an eye on the chat real quick.
Sounds good.
Shelby, mm-hmm. You need to answer this question. Are you ready for it?
No. Go ahead.
Okay. You actually might know this, by the way.
Mm-hmm.
What is Michael Pao's favorite anime?
Oh, Jesus.
I'm just here to miss. I'm here to piss off my co-host. I absolutely enjoy this. So, while you think about that, and Marcus,
I don't need to think. Go ahead.
Okay, punishment. Is it a punishment?
No. It's Corey in the House.
Oh my God! Oh. She pulled it off. She pulled it off with the timer. Oh, Michael Powell, Michael Powell is actually the host of Toyzilla Alive. He's actually staying around to hang out with us. He actually decided to try and troll. And Shelby just nailed the answer. Nicely done. Okay, Shelby, we get to be nice to you this time. So, let's see here. This time, let's see. You know what? I'm going to keep this very... I'm going to be very nice to you. Turn left. This time, I will do it. There you go. Have fun.
Oh.
Yep, there you go. Have fun. Good. Congratulations. Okay, Marcus, have you picked a question from the chat?
Yes.
Okay, so this is the last one for the punishment, the Batsu game that Shelby's going to do. By the way, if you're ever curious, those Japanese Batsu games, like 24-hour tag, nothing short of amazing. Those are absolutely awesome to watch. So, Marcus has selected a question. This is for all the marbles here. This determines whether Shelby gets to eat or if they're going to put another random object in her mouth. Okay. On that note, Marcus, fire away.
In the modern remake of the anime, Osomatsu-san, what is the name of the fourth brother in the Osomatsu family?
Ivory, I'm going to fucking kill you. Or Mandy. It's one of you.
Mm-hmm. What is it? You have. I'm gonna start the timer now.
What?
All right, 30. Four. Wait, there's a 30-second timer on there. Perfect.
All right. It on screen?
Yeah, it's on screen. I'm literally tracking your timer right now.
I don't need it. I've never seen that.
Are you?
Four. Yellow. See the yellow one?
That actually would have helped with one of our previous questions. Blue, no yellow. Nice reference to Monty Python and the Holy Grail. That's all right, though. So are you tapping out?
I'm tapping out.
All right. She taps out, and that's 30 seconds. What is the answer?
The answer
is
Ichimatsu.
Ichimatsu. Okay. So here we go. Final object. Marcus, please take it away. What could go into Shelby's mouth? Phrasing.
Lean back.
Lean back. You gotta keep it. Oh my god.
Oh god, I got all of
it. I just want everyone to know that Shelby did this to herself.
Yeah, no one here prompted her to
Can
do that.
Can that be my eulogy too?
Yeah. Here lies Shelby McWeeb. She did it to herself. Oh, God. Okay, so, folks, if you're just tuning in or if you've been here the entire time, thanks for joining us on Anime Weekly, your one-stop shop for all topics anime and anime-related news. Your hosts, Andrew J. Landy and Shelby McWeeb, who is currently suffering from a case of what was in my mouth, right? Okay, she's speechless. That's fine. Our guest for this evening is Marcus Chavez from Okamoto Kitchen. Marcus, thank you so much for joining us here. You have delicious food in front of you. Is that correct?
We all have delicious food in front of us.
We do. We definitely do. So, again, folks, if you like what you're seeing, please make sure you've liked Anime Weekly on Facebook. And, of course, make sure you've liked Nerdbot as well. That's where you're watching from. Also, make sure that you give a chance. Check out Okamoto Kitchen. They've got not just food. I mean, you see all the food that is up here, and it's all amazing food. But they've also got great gear going on. Again, they've got Maid Haru. This is like a prototype figurine.
It's a very, very fragile prototype.
Yeah, like I can't even put my hand near it. It's that fragile right now. So on top of that, excellent T-shirts. We've got some T-shirts that we're rocking right now. So again, head over to what's the website again?
So you can actually get it to it from our main website, okamotokitchen.com. Uh-huh. Mm-hmm. There will be a splash screen that prompts you whether you want to see sweet merchandise or delicious Japanese comfort food. Uh-huh. And if you just wanted to go directly to the merchandise shop, we have another address for that, and that is okamotok-shop.com. Mm-hmm.
Okay. Very good. Very good. Okay, people think that the show is ending, but it's not ending just yet. By the way, if you guys need those links, they are right above us. They are floating above us in this little area right here above Queen Bee's head. Okay, good stuff. But I do understand it might be time for some trivia, because I understand we have some stuff to give away. Is that correct?
That is correct.
Okay, so I hope you're not all trivia'd out. Do you have your trivia questions ready for the crowds?
Yeah, definitely.
Okay, so, folks, if you're here, first of all, make sure that if you like Okamoto Kitchen on Instagram, check out their social media, check out their website. Make sure you take a look at the great stuff that they have. Make sure you've also liked Anime Weekly and you've also liked Nerdbot. That's also a prerequisite for making sure that you could win. So three lucky winners. Is that right? It's three?
Three winners tonight.
Three winners tonight will be getting some epic swag courtesy of Okamoto Kitchen. Again, fine purveyors of great food. You can catch them at many different events. A lot of them being anime conventions. You might have seen them at Anime Expo, Anime Los Angeles, just to name a few. Possibly, we're not going to guarantee anything just yet because nothing's set in stone, but who knows? At a future event like Anime Pasadena, they could be there. We don't know yet because, again, nothing's confirmed. So before we do that, we did get a question. What is the sandwich you are eating right now?
So I already actually answered it in the chat. And okay. The sandwich I'm eating right now is the katsu curry sandwich.
Katsu curry. Okay, perfect. So we've got a bunch of these right now. I have the JFC in front of me. Is that
JFC plate.
JFC plate, which has salad, so I can get my greens, and then I can get my delicious... going to eat. Shelby, what are you eating right now?
I'm eating curry, and I deserve this.
Yeah, you actually do deserve that, because you did some work. Okay, so... all right, without further ado, so... the way this is going to work... Marcus, I might need you to keep an eye on the chat, because...
Sounds good.
Yeah, you're the one who knows the answers to your trivia questions. When you see the first person to answer the question correctly, shout it out. Now, again... no repeat winners, please. We want three different winners for all this. Does that sound fair for everybody? Is that good? Good? Marcus? Shelby?
Yes.
We good?
Oh,
okay, perfect. Okay, so Marcus, for the first question, go ahead and ask it. And get first person to answer it out, call it out, and we'll make note of who wins it. Okay, are we ready?
Ready.
All right, I'll note down who wins it. I'm taking down notes. Take it away.
In our web shop... we have a pinup version of Haru. What is the year that this shirt is named after?
Okay, so the pinup version of Haru, and there's a year that the shirt is named after. It's on the website. Is that correct?
That is correct.
Okay, so if anybody's on the website right now, that's probably your best bet to get some answers. What is the year? Or you can just guess a random year.
You can catch it on our Facebook page as well. We recently posted new model photos of that specific shirt.
Okay. And this is, again, for which prize right now?
So first prize is going to be the vinyl keychain set.
Vinyl keychain set. So the vinyl keychain set. Okay, so answers are coming in right now. What do we see?
See, Ivory Eye is saying 1964. That is wrong.
That's not... okay, so it's not 1964. That rules out 1 year. Again, folks, so the hint here is you got to go to the Okamoto kitchen, the Okamoto shop, and see. What's the question again before we forget?
Nizer Dizon,
you are the proud winner of the vinyl keychain set. So vinyl keychain, I'm writing that down right now. Sorry, I'm talking off mic because I'm writing. There we go. Sorry about that. Okay, so Nizer, you're a limit. So you win the winner of the first vinyl keychains. We have two more prizes to give away, folks. So Marcus, if you can go ahead with the next question.
So the next question relates to our food.
Okay.
What are the two styles that you can get our JFC in?
Oh, so you were paying attention during the show.
Two-part question. You need both parts.
So we need both styles of the JFC. Is that correct?
That is correct. What is the names? Okay. What are the menu option names? You can find that on our menu on our website as well.
Mm-hmm. As Shelby takes a delicious bite of the JFC. Is that correct? Is this like part trivia, part mukbang right now?
A little bit.
All right, I like it. Okay, so again, the question being, for the JFC, what are the two styles that you can get it, order it? Okay, so...
Dana gets it.
Dana Dinwen gets it. That was the answer we have here. So Dana, you are the proud winner. Tell him what he's won.
So you've won our... acrylic charm set. It's a six-piece set.
Acrylic charm set, courtesy of Okamoto Kitchen. All right. So Nizer Dizon gets the vinyl keychain set. Dana Nguyen gets the acrylic charm set. All right. And now it's time for the big grand Mac Daddy of them all. Is that correct?
Grand prize. Grand prize is winner's choice of one T-shirt.
Ooh.
From our new line.
Okay, so before we ask that question, where can the people find the T-shirts if they are the winners?
Where can they find them if they're the winners? You can find them on our e-commerce site on okamotok-shop.com.
Okay, perfect. So if you don't know which one you want, Shelby, Marcus, and I are all wearing different shirts. Well, Marcus and I are kind of wearing the same shirt in two different styles. Shelby's got the top-tier waifu shirt. Is that right?
Yep.
That's correct.
Perfect. So, and there's also a couple others as well. So, all right. So, final winner. And again, if you need that link, it is right above you just to look at it. But All right, grand prize winner, here we go. Marcus, fire away.
So I'm going to mention something that has no relation to anything that we said in the chat.
That's perfect.
Or in the stream.
Okay, that's fine.
Name three Makoto Shinkai movies that do not include your name.
Three Makoto Shinkai movies that, like, excluding your name.
Excluding your name.
This is why I came.
Okay, so let's see. Who can get it? Three of them. Makoto Shinkai movies. Your name is excluded. You are not allowed to use your name. First person to get it wins it. And again, Marcus is the one who is commanding the chat right now.
Are there any anime film festivals you can maybe watch them at?
Mm.
So there recently was an animation film festival called Animation Is Film that was held in Hollywood recently. And they actually spotlighted Shinkai, and Shinkai himself was there.
Mm.
Do we have an answer in there?
Is that correct?
We need one more.
We need one more.
One more.
So that's only two? Okay, so Josh, it looks like you only had two.
Anthony gets it.
Anthony Gonzalez, you are the winner. Anthony Gonzalez, congratulations. Okay, so what's going to happen, folks? What we need, I'll need you guys to message the Anime Weekly page, again, with your name and email. We're going to forward your information over to Okamoto Kitchen. That way, you guys can talk with them, eliminate the middleman, and we'll determine where to get everything sent out. But again, to Nazar Dizan, the winner of the vinyl keychain set, Dana Dinwen, the winner of the acrylic charm key set, and Anthony Gonzalez, grand prize winner, wins a t-shirt courtesy of Okamoto Kitchen. Again, visit okamotokitchen.com. Is that correct?
Yes.
And okamotok-shop.com. That link is right above us for all of your food menu and, of course, Okamoto Kitchen apparel needs. Great job, everybody. It's so cool. Okay, so I guess we're coming to the end of the show right here. First of all, Marcus, thank you so much for coming through with Okamoto Kitchen. It was just great. Any last words to say to the crowds here before we call it?
If you've come to the truck in the past and supported us, we really appreciate it. It means a lot. The community are what keeps us alive. We have our daily lunch stops. But thank you for letting us be a part of the community and, you know, bring a smile to your faces and feed your empty bellies at cons. Just seeing everyone that comes out to all these events is really great. And to see repeat customers that really care, you know, about our food or what we're doing, our brand, what we have planned in the future, it really means a lot. So thank you.
Okay. So is Okamoto Kitchen only on Instagram, or can they follow you guys elsewhere?
So you can actually follow us on many services. So you can follow us on the standard Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, but you can also find us on Pinterest.
Pinterest, okay. Very good.
And
Amazon,
then,
Etsy, eBay.
Yeah, Amazon, Etsy, eBay.
Mm-hmm. Excellent. Okay, so, just for our edification, Marcus, can we follow you anywhere as well? Aside from just Okamoto Kitchen, is there anything else you'd like to promote out?
You can follow me at MarcusChavez93 at Instagram. You can see all of the conventions that I work for and all of the guests in the community that we play that I work with and help them out. Lots of photos like that.
Excellent. And one last question: where will we see Okamoto Kitchen next?
The next one, you'll see us at Anime Impulse.
Impulse, okay.
Anime Impulse.
We're gonna have the truck there, and we're also going to have our first merchandise booth inside the exhibit hall.
Nice. Congratulations. So if you guys didn't get a chance, if you're not able to order it out off the website, if you'd like to see it in person, Anime Impulse, you'll have the booth there, and of course, delicious food. Is that correct?
That's correct.
All right, Shelby. Okay, are you recovered from the Botsu game?
I apologize if I cussed too much or made any tasteless jokes. I was hungry, so it came up worse.
On that note, where should we be following you?
You can follow me at the Bombshell Cosplay on Instagram, Shelby McWeeb, SHELLBEEMCWEEB on Twitter, Bombshell Cosplay on Facebook, or you can like Anime Weekly to subscribe to weekly videos like this.
Yes. My name is Andrew J. Alandi. You can follow me at Andrew J. Alandi on Instagram and Twitter or Facebook as well. Most importantly, though, make sure you guys follow Anime Weekly, facebook.com/myanimeweekly. We're just past 500. We're past 500 likes, so thank you guys for everybody who's tuned in, everybody who's said hi. Also, make sure you've liked Nerdbot. That is also important. That's where you're watching. And above all, make sure you love yourself, guys. Thank you so much again for joining us. That about does it for this week's edition of Anime Weekly. Again, thank you so much to Okamoto Kitchen for coming in. If you could hear the music right now, that's actually some of their closing theme music, courtesy of Okamoto Kitchen. So not just food, not just merchandise, but also epic music too. So again, thank you guys. Thank you, Okamoto Kitchen, for coming out. Thank you to all the viewers that are here. Again, guys, we'll see you next time. Take care and have a great evening. And now watch us eat.